Welcome to another week of the Real Football right here on Swire FM 99.9. We're right here in the middle of Blacktown. There's a circus outside. There's a circus in here. There's always a circus in here. That's what it's about. Anthony, Luke, joined by you two again. How you guys going?
Good, good. How you guys going?
Yeah, I'm awesome in full kit, boys, because I'm pumped.
He's kitted up.
Head to toe, lads.
Are you going
head
to Melbourne?
Big pardon?
Are you going to Melbourne on Friday night?
I'm going to the game in Sydney. Yes, I am.
But not the Melbourne game.
I don't tolerate Melbourne victory. I don't believe in Melbourne. So I just talk about Sydney side.
Yeah, Sydney's just playing Manchester City on Saturday night. But we'll get to that later. We'll preview all the A-League teams, fixture, you know, in sequence. We'll also talk about the Socceroos because they play on Saturday morning at 1 o'clock this Monday, or Saturday morning,
Saturday
I should
morning.
Say. Or Friday night, however you look at it. But we've all forgotten about the Socceroos because it's just the A-League's been in full swing.
Can I say, thank God the A-League's back.
Oh my God, Tell you what, I am so relieved. Well, for us Wanderers supporters, we've been back for a while.
Here we go.
But it's good to see that the neighbours are finally on the ball.
I kind of wouldn't like my under break, actually. But
yeah,
anyway.
That's story. I mean, we got that World Club Championship comeback in December. I'm joking.
Probably 2 games away from Real Madrid.
And 3 games away from the final. But anyway, we'll talk about the fixtures later on. Each team, starting off with Wanderers travelling to Melbourne Victory. Two marquee fixtures this week. Sydney playing Melbourne in both. But again, we'll talk about that. F3 Derby as well on Saturday afternoon.
And the longest domestic football game the world.
The distance derby. Don't worry about Manchester United and Liverpool. It's about Wellington and Perth.
And of course, rounding out the weekend, I think is going to be... played second fiddle to the other two games. Is Brisbane and Adelaide.
But
that's going to be a great game.
But I do believe that'll probably be the most entertaining fixture of the lot.
I think so. It's going
to
be a great game.
Probably two teams
better
that play
than
the most
distance derby?
They call it... they actually label it as a thing. I hate you because you're 6 hours away. Who says that? No one
ever. Depends on daylight saving, but yeah.
We don't want to get too technical. It's a distance star, but you've got to let it stay back. But we also have Simon Hill later on to the show to help us preview the A-League season. We might talk about the Socceroos as well, where he sees Ange Postecoglou and his boys at. And we'll talk about Tim Cahill because it's been a very interesting week for him, especially in America. He's been having a little bit of a feud with his New York Red Bull coach and fans,
yeah.
But we'll talk about that later. We're going to get to a song first. This is Addicted to You by Avicii. When we come back, we're going to talk all things A-League, kick off with Melbourne Victory, Western Sydney Wanderers, and then the Socceroos. Stay tuned.
I don't know just how it happened. I let down my guard. Swore I'd never fall in love again. But I fell hard. Guess I should have seen it coming. Caught me by surprise. Wasn't looking where I was going. I fell into your eyes. You came into my crazy world like a cool and cleansing rain. Before I knew what hit me, baby, you were flowing through my veins. I'm addicted to you.
Local A-League gear to your overseas supporters gear and lots more. Jason caters for all sizes, including toddlers. Plus the best NRL supporters gear, football boots, casual and running shoes, and sports equipment. IM Sports, Carnes Hill, Marketplace, Cow Pasture Road at Horningsea Park. Awarded 2014's Liverpool City's Best Business. IM Sport is a sponsor of Swar FM.
Welcome back to Swar FM 90.9. This is The Real Football. We're going to talk things all about football right up till 4 o'clock. Then we'll hand over to Rancid JD for Swar Drive 46. You can cash out every Monday to Friday for your latest traffic, news, weather. And it's always like a nice hot topic that he likes to talk about. Plus, he's got a sweet Americano voice that just puts you to sleep in the most surreal and nice way. I just gave him a compliment. I've never done that on air, or really to his face. I'm an honest man. I call it how it is. But we're going to talk about Melbourne Victory versus Western Sydney Wanderers. Broadcast starts about 7:30 on Fox Sports and on SBS 1 this time. Mm-hmm. SBS finally picking up their game. Well, Victory versus Wanderers, how do you guys see it?
What a game to start the season, I think. I think this is the game that needed to happen. I don't think a Melbourne derby, as they've done in the previous years, would have been just not quite yet.
They've always been disappointing at round one.
Yes, they need a lead up because teams need to get into their groove. But for the Wanderers, I mean, they can only go further than what they have already. I mean, incredible preseason they've had. Although they haven't, Popovich said that he hasn't had the ideal preseason, meaning that not a lot of players have had a lot of minutes in the legs because they've been limited with the Asian Champions League. Mm-hmm. It's still been an
incredible
preseason.
Would you even call it a preseason? You can't call it a preseason because
Popovich said it himself. It's not.
They've really been in the full swing for the past few months.
But against a Melbourne Victory side who look like they've just gotten better from last season, mm-hmm. I mean, Berisha is just going to make so much of a difference. But Carl Valeri as well, I think he will probably be, he's going to be an X factor in there. It's going to be difficult for Broxham and Milligan mm-hmm. to, you know, especially for Broxham to fight for a place in there.
And another interesting signing, they replaced Adama Traore, who's probably been the best left back in the league for the past few seasons after he left Gold Coast United. Daniel Georgiovski, a Macedonian international, but he's right here from Blacktown. Mm. Probably he was born in that park right outside the studio where the circus is at the moment. But he played in the Champions League last year for Steaua Bucharest, played against Chelsea, played all the group games. And it's a quality signing for Melbourne Victory. And it was an area that they really needed to strengthen, and they did.
Yeah.
A really experienced campaigner.
Especially losing someone like Traore, he was instrumental.
Exactly. And last season, one of their biggest issues was being clinical in front of goals. And they went on and signed probably the greatest striker the A-League's ever seen, Bersat Berisha. I have them as my favourites. We'll get to that later. We all have our views on what's going to happen at the end of the A-League. But you're right, Victory and Wanderers is probably the best way to start off the season.
I think so.
With Victory, you mentioned them. I would have them as the strongest team depth-wise. They have the best depth of any team in the A-League by far. They've got a Tunisian international, Justin Khalifa.
Yes, he played in Liga.
And then for Bordeaux,
Past few months, in the January transfer window, he dropped out of tier, but he's still quality.
And he probably won't even start on the weekend. He's struggling to get in the top 11.
And we're forgetting your French mate as well, Curtis.
Del Pierre.
Yes, the one.
My mate.
Stuttgart.
Mathieu Del Pierre.
Exactly right. He's going to be
defense. He's a solid defense. He's won the Bundesliga as captain for Stuttgart only in 2008, only six years ago. He's played for Utrecht. That's why Guillaume Serrada and Orr recommended him to the... Well, he asked about the A-League and obviously they're going to give it positive reviews. Serrada's back as well. We'll talk about that later. But like you said, Melbourne is quality. It's not just quantity, it's quality. And that's what...
How do they fit it?
Smart. Just smart. Del Pierre, I mean, a few years ago, Del Pierre would have been a marquee, and he's not. A few years ago, Duff would have been a marquee. Andy Carroll would have been a marquee, even though he's just a championship player. We've really improved, not only on the pitch, but business-wise as well.
Definitely, yeah.
So, results. Victory Wanderers.
Oh, it's just too tough to call a result here, because both these sides, I mean, first of all, I don't know, Luke, we're talking about this off-air, which side is going to come for the Wanderers? Which team's going to turn up? Mm. We have no idea.
Well, all we know is that Juric, even though he's got ruled out of the Socceroos camp, he did deem himself available for the game. So he might come off the bench. We don't know. Nothing has been said. Topor Stanley's obviously with the Socceroos, and Smirnovic is still recovering from an injury. Hopefully, he'll be back for the Asian Champions League in a few weeks.
Yeah, who partners Hamu in defence?
Golek or Mullen, because you can still put Cole as a fullback. He wasn't used there for the Champions League. I think he only played half a game as a fullback.
Is it what your left back Mullen? No, what's
the left back that they signed is Sadie Aleke.
He's still waiting the international clearance, I think so.
Yeah. So you put Golek at left back. You can put Mullen to shift him into his natural position at centre back.
You got Alessi to slot
and you got Alessi right or you got Cole. So there is depth at the Wanderers as well as Victory, and these young kids are showing that the Wanderers actually have quality in their depth.
No, I think Wanderers definitely takes one out because, look, to be honest, who have Melbourne Victory placed in the last 3 months? No one. Wanderers are facing everyone.
The only thing the most interesting battle I find in this matchup is Berisha up against Hamill and probably Mullen, even if it's Golek and they put him as a centre-back, put Colin left. Because Berisha is accustomed to playing against Branovic and Topor Stanley, even Buchum. So this is going to be a new surroundings new, for Hamill and things. But they've shown that they can do it because they play in the Champions League.
They're not playing Hamill. They're not playing Malin. They're playing Popovic. It doesn't matter. So
they've all turned into little Popoviches. Yeah,
Popovic can put anyone there and they're a superstar. So I don't care who's in the team.
That's the thing.
Put the youth squad on. We'll win.
You can trust the Wanderers squad because Popovic picks them for a reason. You know, he doesn't just pick them.
Well, Saba said he's never been to a club where Popovic will clearly come out and said that if you don't train well, you're not playing. You can score a hat trick the week before, but if you don't train well during the week, there's no way you're playing.
And that's how it should be.
Exactly right.
That's how it should
be. Wanderers had like a 2-week break between Champions League matches, and what do? They go to Dubai and they do double sessions in 40-degree heat. This is Popovic. He is ruthless.
Popovic has the mindset of an international manager, and he's like opened a lot of doors for other A-League managers. Yeah.
Well, Ono said it's the toughest place he's ever trained in his whole life by a mile.
And he found like a new lease of life here because he came on fit. He was bagged out in Japan. They called him done. And now look who's off.
Popovic, it's not going to be too long before he's gone, and he's going to be, you know, one of the managers that every European team is going to be chasing. Yeah. And good luck to him because he deserves it for what he's done with Western Sydney.
So Western Sydney play Melbourne Victory at the Etihad Stadium.
Thank God as well.
Expecting a big crowd.
And by the way, just talking Western Sydney, who said 2-0 comfortable win? Who said that last week?
Oh, wow. Comfortable FC Seoul.
And you guys were like, oh, 2-0 Seoul.
I'll admit, we expected FC Seoul to play football.
They just had nothing.
They were not there.
So I was exactly right.
Props to Luke.
I stood tall.
Well done.
And you guys were way against me. Just have it on record. Right?
Well done.
Oh, he's been holding that in for the past week. I probably waited until the full time.
That's all I could think about during the game. I was right. That's all that matters.
Anyway, after that game, not straight after, a few hours later, you can get like a little power nap because you're going to all have to wake up at 1:30 Saturday morning. Australia played UAE in Dubai. Shockers. We need some wins. We got one. Our last fixture, we got a win against Saudi Arabia, but it was a tough win. You know, made it work. Probably played it harder for ourselves.
Definitely, yeah.
We've new squad, a lot of new players coming back, like James Cherisi, and new additions like Bernie Abini and Topor Stanley.
As is Beige as well, who's
and that's his Beige, you know, playing well in Turkey. How do you see this one going out?
Oh, you can't see anything more than a Socceroos win. It has to be.
You'd hope
it just
so.
It has to be. You'd hope so, and you'd think so. I mean, the squad that we've picked is, you know, whilst it's half experimental, half probably the team he's going to take to the Asian Cup, it's a quality squad.
Well, he's still sticking by the stance of the last squad where he went, I'm going to pick a national pool.
Well, Bernie Abini, even though I predicted it, who would have thought that? But
look at you guys with your predictions.
Even though I predicted it. It's like he spent the whole day just working out how he was going to slide that one. A lot of people predicted that.
Well,
anyway.
He bragged about it from the get-go. Gets announced. I'm like, oh, Topor Stanley got in. I predicted a beanie. Good job, Anthony. Good job. Well done.
Do you see Topor Stanley playing in this game, or do you think that
he has to play in at least one? Because Popovic, when he picks players, especially for two friendly games, he uses them. Well, he doesn't not just like leave them there for.
Do you think Postecoglou in the back of his mind? I know he's only thinking about Australia, but do you think he, especially for a beanie and Topor Stanley as well, does he have in the back of his mind? Okay, I'll play him in the first game. And I won't play him in the second game. That way there's a possibility they can play for the A-League.
It could be in the back A-League. Of his mind, but the way that he's said in the media, Australia's first.
Mm.
And he's been an A-League coach. He knows what it's like to be affected from not having international breaks in his competition.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe in the back of the mind, his mind, yes, because he would be a bit lenient, but he won't say it.
No, 100%, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. And I think Anthony, just for viewers at home, Anthony's been wearing a beanie all week, just to subtly remind everyone. Just
oh, my God.
He ordered a Sydney FC shirt with a beanie. Ordered a Socceroos shirt with a beanie.
Yeah, so just to let you know that.
And fun fact, Anthony was actually a Central Coast fan until a few months ago. He was also a Parramatta fan. Was he from Parramatta or from Western Sydney somewhere?
Western Sydney, yeah.
Sorry, you, fun fact. Eastern Sydney. But Tim Cahill. He's probably Australia's greatest athlete. I'm going to say it. Sorry, Kathy Freeman, I love you, but Tim Cahill.
Man's man, woman's man, every kind of man.
His son's a Broadway man.
It's clearly not Justin New York's. It's clearly not the New York
not
man.
New York's man at the moment, because MLS, like the A-League, and like some Asian leagues as well, they don't stop for international breaks. Mm. The American League, if you guys don't know, goes through the calendar year. So like the Asian leagues as well. Yep. So they're obviously getting to a pivotal moment throughout the season. They're still struggling to wrap up a final spot. They're only about 2 points.
One, two points
out of their playoffs.
Yep.
And the coach is a bit furious that Tim Cahill was putting two friendlies before his club's needs. Also other fans. And Tim Cahill just went, in a nice way, obviously, because he's a gentleman, shut up.
Pretty much.
That's what he said. I'm Australian, you can get stuffed.
And you know what the funny thing was? He started on the bench just this previous week, but he went on the field and he actually got sent off. Meaning
3 minutes, first red card ever.
Meaning there is no possible way he would be able to play in these games anyway.
The only way to make your coach forgive you after getting sent off for 3 minutes wasting a substitute is by going halfway across the world in the most important time of your season.
That's the funniest part. But look, is this an opportunity for A-League clubs to capitalise on this? He's only got 1 year left on his MLS contract. It's if he seems that he's unhappy there, the fans are unhappy with him, his coach is unhappy with him. Is it a chance for A-League clubs to capitalise?
He thinks he's too good for the A-League, so I don't think he'll come back.
Well, that's what he said before the likes of Del Piero, Ono and Heskey.
He said it in a nice way. He said the MLS is of a quality standard.
He's changed his tune.
Ever since he came to Australia with Postecoglou and played Costa Rica and he went to a game, he was like, oh, right, these guys can play football.
Exactly right. So is it a chance for us to capitalise?
Maybe, but like, I love Cahill, but someone who loves Cahill more than me is himself. So, like,
he's no Lukasz Nildo.
No, he's nothing like Lukasz Nildo. No way.
Well, we mentioned before that Cahill's Red Bull coach said, due to Socceroos, he's going to spend a lot of time just not starting for a while, you know? And if the tax evasion thing comes through, he'll also be going to court, where he'll also spend a lot of time sitting on the bench. And having got a red card on the weekend, have more time to rest his case.
Well, that's a good thing for Paul Socceroglu.
I mean, feet, sorry. Sorry,
that's a good thing for Paul Socceroglu. You get more out of Tim Cahill because he won't be playing for a... No, just maybe a week or two. Plus, you know, he's in the naughty corner at New York. So once he gets back, he has, you know, a space to do his tax evasion.
I suppose.
Not tax, it's just tax issues. Something. We're not a financial review show, right? We're
Although,
about football.
That's true. Although if I'm Tim Cahill and I'm getting paid $3 million to sit on a bench, I wouldn't mind that at all.
I was watching the LA Galaxy because I got really bored in the lecture last week. He was playing as a holding midfielder. Yes, he's a midfielder, but a holding midfielder. He's also played as a striker. Yeah. He's played at left midfield. He's played as a number 10. He's like New York's utility.
Why?
I don't know.
I just put him up front. He's
did they not watch the World Cup?
Yeah, I know.
Did they not see that goal?
They tried to buy Tony Hibbert, but he was unavailable. So
Tony Hibbert's still trying to get his breath from trying to chase Raheem Sterling and Angel Di Maria in space of 2 weeks.
He's been seeing shadows still. Reports are,
Yeah, he's a bit hallucinating.
What do you think about the game against Qatar? You reckon obviously another win?
Hopefully. Again, look, you hope so. But in the Middle East, we always make it's tough to play in the Middle East, especially when most of these players are coming from Europe, where the temperatures are nowhere near.
Well, interestingly enough, this is going to be just about the time when the 2022 World Cup will be held.
No, it's going to be in Australia, don't worry.
So, you know, it's good. We're acclimatising about 8 years early.
If we did lose, it would be a catastrophe, so we'll try.
We need to win. I actually looked at the FIFA rankings.
He doesn't even hear
him.
He doesn't even hear my goal.
guys, please, I'm controlling like four things at once. But I was looking at the FIFA rankings. Apparently, according to FIFA, we're the 10th best team in Asia.
Yeah.
I don't know if anybody's like, realize we've all talked about our
dip. We've talked about this before. I personally despise the rankings with a passion.
According to FIFA, worse than the two teams that we're going to play. So if we win, it's actually going to boost us.
Look, if Anthony hates him, that's it.
We do what Anthony does because he's just a prediction king. We follow what he says.
Yep.
I mean, he's going to win the World Cup 2018, is that what you're saying? He's going to win the Golden Ball.
Top goal scorer. What is Thomas Muller?
Ballon d'Or with Real Madrid when he signs at the end of the season. Is that what you're saying, Anthony?
Yeah, we'll go with that.
If this happens, oh my God, I'm going to marry you. Is This Love by Bob Marley. Stay tuned for more Swire FM. Simon Hill soon will also talk about the rest of the A-League fixtures coming up this weekend. Stay tuned, Swire FM.
Is everything from your local A-League gear to your overseas supporters gear and lots more. Jason caters for all sizes, including toddlers. Plus the best NRL supporters gear, football boots, casual and running shoes, and sports equipment. IM Sports, Carnes Hill, Marketplace, Cow Pasture Road at Horningsea Park. Awarded 2014's Liverpool City's Best Business. IM Sport is a sponsor of Swar FM.
Welcome back to Swar FM 9.9. This is the real football. We're talking all things football, all things A-League today, actually. Don't worry about Europe. That's where all the minors are. Don't worry about this English Premier League and Chelsea beating Arsenal 2-0.
Oh, when the A-League started.
Don't worry about us and Wenger shoving Jose Mourinho. We're talking about the A-League. We're talking about the biggest derby in the world. Not the London derby. No, not the Merseyside derby.
Not even
no.
The Sydney derby.
Not even the derby in Buenos Aires last weekend where Boca Juniors drew 1-1 with River Plate. Not about that.
I
that's
feel
not
like
passion.
We are talking about it now, though, kid.
That's not passion. No, no. We're going to elaborate on the mighty F3 derby. The derby where one road, one piece of road.
It's actually the M1 now. It's kind of awkward.
I didn't see it as a derby anyway. The Centricos are hosting Newcastle Jets. Broadcast starts at 5 Saturday night on Fox Sports before the headline where Mr. David Villa rocks up against Sydney FC. Hopefully, but we'll talk about that later on. Central Coast and Newcastle. Both teams, I would say, have improved their squad, especially Newcastle. It's going to be interesting with a new coach, Phil Stubbins, getting his shot at the A-League, which is really good to see a young coach, young Australian coach, getting more opportunities.
He's brought in a lot of players.
And he has. Newcastle have really overhauled their squad. You know, they've lost Josh Brillante, he's went to Fiorentina. Adam Taggart's gone to Fulham. Ruben Zatkovic, their captain's moved on to Perth. I don't know why you want to live in Perth. I've lived there. It's not that great. But Newcastle have overhauled their squad. It's going to be interesting to see how they go. Yeah. First test, a big test. I haven't beaten Central Coast in quite a while. How do you see this one going?
Flores Flavor.
I think so. He did have a little bit of a shot at his club yesterday.
He had a dig at the Central Coast Mariners. He basically said that they have no support and that's why he left.
And they screwed him over with
exactly,
his injury.
Exactly
and
right.
His knee had no support. That's why he was in trouble.
So. That's exactly right. So he's already starting to throw shots at them even though
shots
it doesn't matter
fired.
Shots fired even though it doesn't matter because it's an F3 derby. I mean, like, if it was a Sydney derby, different story. But like,
right, Anthony,
don't even say that.
A match that means lots to them and to no one else.
Exactly right.
It's like the distance derby.
Don't bring that into this. Sorry, Anthony, continue.
They have brought in some quality players. Adrian Madashi, Billy Selesky, who was, you know, one
injured
of the
injured though.
He is, but he was one of the best players at Melbourne Victory.
He was an all-star.
He was. Geronimo as well. He's been a fantastic scorer away from Hindmarsh, so Geronimo. It's going to be interesting to see.
Well, it's going to be good to see Geronimo actually start more games this season.
Yeah.
Because last year he was clinical, but he played about 30 minutes a game.
Edison Montano as well is on loan from...
That's going to be interesting because, let's be honest, probably no one knows much about him.
Mm-hmm. Exactly right. And Johnny Steele, former teammate of Tim Kay, who is of high regard of Tim. So it's going to be interesting.
Reckon he got bagged out of New York as well?
Oh, that's why he left, yeah, 100%.
It'll be hard for the Jets because they have 4 straightaway games. Hunter Stadium is out of action for over a month, so that's really tough. And I think this is the worst Mariners outfit we've seen in recent history.
But this is the thing, though. You never write off the Mariners on paper.
Yeah, but that's because they had Arnold, though, before.
No, even without Arnold, with McKinnon, first season, they did not look like a good team. They made it to the grand final.
Yeah, but that was when the A-League was, like, all over the shop.
Though. Yeah, but still.
But you look at the seasons after that, they've been the most consistent team in the league.
Central probably had about, like, one horrible season.
They've been top 3 in the last 5 years.
Exactly. You cannot write them off.
But I don't know if the Aussie Battlers is going to take him another season in the top 4. They'd be lucky to make the 6. I have them out of my 6.
I do as well, but I just, something tells me that I just can't write them off.
For me, Central Coast, Wellington, you can't write them off. Yeah. But they are out of my 6, but you can never predict the 6 with the A-League. It's probably the most unpredictable league in the world. But Central Coast, they signed Malik Mane, highly regarded by Phil Moss, on loan from Gothenburg in Sweden. So it should be interesting. His pace, he's a pace winger. So
I watched him play. Like, I wasn't like, he was probably the worst player on the field, and they played Wellington Phoenix that day. So like, I'm not excited for them.
Well, it is preseason
at all.
We'll wait and see with the Central Coast. That's the thing. It's one of those clubs, like Newcastle as well, with a massive overhaul, and like Wellington. It's just, we'll wait and we'll see. They're not more established like Victory and the Wanderers and Sydney FC. It's more of a new transition for these clubs.
Yeah.
So it would be an interesting F3 derby. But straight after 7:30 on Fox Sports, the big match, Sydney FC versus Melbourne City, or Manchester City, however you want to look at it. David Villa, would he be starting?
Well, no. I think they've not confirmed, or all but confirmed, that he will be playing from the bench this week. So you can't expect a guy who just flew in on Tuesday to start, especially you know, as much as training he can do on his own. He doesn't speak English for one, so that's just going to be another barrier that he has to get over. He doesn't even know his teammates' names. So I mean, even though he is who he is, it's just,
and when you're forced to have your best friend as Jonathan Germano, you know, it's not going to be fun. Yeah.
Well, apparently, he has his mind at Ranieri here, just following him every footstep. So I don't know if Ranieri's going to run on the field, and like if someone attacks him or fouls him badly.
It's not much of a Lippy.
So I don't know, but I think this is the there's four players who are World Cup goal scorers, finals goal scorers in this fixture, with Duff, Corran, Villa, and Smiles.
Smiles.
So that's four World Cup finals goals. I think it's a record for the A-League.
Wow, one New Zealander made the list.
The problem
you have a World Cup winner there and someone from New Zealand.
The problem for me with Melbourne City is the attack is Melbourne City, you know, that's just esque, but the defence just is so much Melbourne heart, in my opinion. I just think, is it just going to be more than a name change, or is it just going to be the old Melbourne Heart?
Because last year, when Melbourne Heart played good football, is when they realised that we have nothing to play for.
Exactly right.
We're just going to play for fun. But when they actually were playing competitively, they were terrible. But you are right. You do make an interesting point, because defensively, it's just Melbourne Heart. Picture Patrick Kisnorbe and Rob Veilhart. They are quality players, but they do need to step up, like Jason Hoffman. And they've trialled Ian Ramsey as left back throughout the preseason. So it's going to be interesting to see how that happens, how that goes in a competitive arena.
Yep.
But the midfield and up, going forward, it's a new team. You know, you got Aaron Moy,
Eric Pardaloo,
Robert Corran, Duff,
Williams.
Same player, but I get what you mean.
Oh, okay.
new lease of life, he means.
New lease of life.
Yes.
New beanies. Is that what you're saying? Is the Williams going to be in the soccer squad?
Mentioned a beanie?
I predicted it.
Oh, we should just give you a pat on the back, huh?
Speaking of a beanie, though.
He's going to be in the Middle East watching a game. Expecting what? A massive crowd on Saturday night?
Upwards of 35, so, well, they're hoping.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But it should be a massive game. And it's a massive game for Sydney. It's a massive game for Graham Arnold. He's talked it up in the preseason. There's no doubt about that. He's talked it up how he's changed the culture. He's changed everything about Sydney FC. Now it's time to put that into action.
I don't know if he can do it on Saturday, because two of his key players are out. I don't think he anticipated to be needed to get into the Socceroos squad. Maybe Yanko, obviously, because he's captain.
And also, he was instrumental in the preseason and last year. Ali Abbas is not there. He's on Iraqi national duty.
Can't forget Ali Abbas.
You guys
going to
mention Ryan Grant was out after when you mentioned key player.
You're not playing?
No, I'm not playing.
He's actually not a bet that he gets to kick you in the face.
Well, there is a bet, but we'll come onto that another day. But Mick Flynn and Grant are out. So how would they?
Mick Flynn. He's retired.
What, you don't rate Mick Flynn?
Terry McFlynn.
Come on. The guy's a legend. I think they're going to make a gargoyle of him on the stadium when he passes. So it's amazing.
Every time he completes a pass.
Yeah.
But Sydney FC, Melbourne City.
Yeah.
I guess we've been anticipating this for a very, very long time, since David Villa was announced and since Melbourne City actually got bought from Manchester City and the whole big city family was founded. Wait, how do you see this going with a lot of absentees? Villa maybe off the bench, Sydney FC without a beanie and Yanko and the Bass, like you just touched on. How do you see this one going out?
Well, as a Sydney fan, I've got to go with Sydney. But even as a football fan, I just see Sydney just having too much for Melbourne City. I think, like I said before, it's just Melbourne Heart for me. Until they prove me wrong, I'm just going to see him as Melbourne Heart at the moment.
I agree. Yeah. Sydney FC, I think it's an easy one for Sydney FC.
Well, I'm going to be the most fun guy in the room and tip a draw.
Sit on the fence.
That's you what we all want to see. See a draw. 1 point. It's those 1 pointers that count.
By the way, Alex Brosk was just named club captain of Sydney FC. An interesting choice. Yeah. Arnold really showed his poker face throughout the preseason, giving the captaincy to Ogunowski and Nikola Petkovic, and then today comes out and says, no, I'm going to give it to Brosk.
So you see Brosk as a leader, though?
I think Ogunowski was the right choice, but I see where Arnold's coming from, being the fan favourite, being a club legend, as he's stated. So
who loves Sydney FC more than Brosk
in the team? That's exactly right.
But he's out.
We're going to get retired.
As a Wanderers fan, I wish he's back in, but we can't.
Oh, man, every time he came on that team sheet, cheers.
Tear of joy.
No, I love you, Terry. You're a great footballer.
He is a great footballer.
Foundation player. We've got to respect him.
Legend.
We're going to get to a song. This is Faded by Temper Trap. Stay tuned. More Real Football, Swire FM 9.9.
IM Sport is everything from your local A-League gear to your overseas supporters gear and lots more. Jason caters for all sizes, including toddlers. Plus the best NRL supporters gear, football boots, casual and running shoes, and sports equipment. IM Sports, Carnes Hill, Marketplace, Cow Pasture Road, and Horningsea Park. Awarded 2014's Liverpool City's Best Business. IM Sport is a sponsor of Swar FM.
If you didn't get that, that was Strut by Lenny Kravitz. I don't know if you said that a few times, but I was Strut by Lenny Kravitz.
It reminds me of Gombau when they score, he sort of struts in the sideline, doesn't he?
Kind of reminds me of
Arsene
Wenger.
What are you talking about?
No, it's Arsene Wenger on the weekend.
Oh, yeah.
Strut, dun,
what round
in Mourinho's face.
What round will Gombau do a streak, guys?
Maybe round one.
You remember round one?
Maybe round one. I don't know. He just seems like he's the dude that would just do it randomly.
He's got to do it in the grand final, I think. Not anything less.
If it's after round 10, I'll be disappointed.
But we'll talk about, we'll do this in sequence. Wellington versus Perth at Wellington at the Caketon. 3 p.m. Sunday. Across the Dutch. Shane Smiltz. Too bad he's not there. Is that your ball now?
Smiltz
with the header to the flag. Beats Italy. Should have won that game. Speaking on behalf of our cousins down south.
Okay, here we go.
Wellington versus Perth. Both squads with a lot of changes, especially Perth. Probably the most changes this season. They went from a lot of kids to a lot of...
Well, as Luke would say, retirement village.
No, Arsenal last season was retirement villages. This season is just men.
Yeah.
Old men.
just men.
Absolutely.
But some of the names they've brought in, I mean, Yusuf Ersi, Dino Djurbic, Ruben Zadkovic, Andy Key... We're talking about old. He's only 28 years old and he's an international.
Exactly, he's still in his prime.
Danny Vukovic returns from his loan spell. Diogo Ferreira, who has won a few championships with Brisbane.
All right, okay, let's stop there. You didn't win it.
Well, you got a medal.
So anyone can get that if they're in the squad.
That doesn't matter. You got a medal. Mitch Nichols and Richard Garcia are all, you know, in that squad. Mm. So it's a lot of
Ferrari's
choice.
Ferrari's going to bring quality to that bench.
Yeah.
I mean, there's not many people who can say, I've won titles and I'm sitting on the bench. It'll be a golden bench.
A lot of them had great pre-seasons. Like Hersey, he had a star performance in Captain Phillips, Academy Award-winning movie, and he was a superstar in that.
That was a great off-season. That's why he was like, no, to the Wonders, I need more money, I'm going to win Academy Award.
Yeah, because his acting is really improved. I think he was outstanding in that role. How do you feel about that, Anthony?
No comment.
No comment, all right. Well, yeah, and they're fighting Wanderers for Rukavica too, so that would be a really amazing buy for either club.
Yeah, exactly. In my opinion, whichever team Rukavica goes to is going to improve their squad indefinitely.
Well, it's either money or
playing for love. Really, playing for tournaments, playing for gold.
Playing for silverware.
Playing to beat Real Madrid. There's not many times where you get to say that.
Absolutely. And the Knox. Are we going to try to do Knox. The whole thing in a Kiwi accent?
Go for it.
Well, the Knox have...
You stop.
They've got a very strong midfield. Probably the strongest midfield. Very strong midfield in A-League. But there's no depth. One of them gets injured. They've got Riera, Burns, McGlinchey. If one of them gets injured, though, they're in trouble. But decent midfield.
Well, when he comes back, even Alejandro Gorin or Rodriguez, however you want it, it's like, I don't know what South Americans like to do with their nails.
He prefers Rodriguez.
It's better than Gorin, to be honest. But he showed his quality in the friendly tournament we've seen yesterday, West Ham Newcastle. He also captained the Sunderland under 21s team last year. Buendovicea, you said that he's injured, but he did consistently play in the Eredivisie last season. You see, he just got relegated. Same reason why Castellan probably packed his bags and moved out our ways as well. So like I touched on earlier, Wellington as well as Newcastle, Central Coast and Perth, it's a big question mark. We don't know what we'll see from them. Because Perth have the history of, we'll have a good side, but we're not going to do much. I mean, they probably only have had one good season in the A-League. It's been disappointing because they're probably the proudest club in this competition.
Yeah, well, they were favourites way back in season one to win the title, and I think they ended up coming second last. So they've got a lot to live up to, and maybe this season might be it. But Kenny Lowe, even though...
Great character.
He is, but how long can he last if they get on a losing streak?
Yeah. Well, that's the trigger finger of Tony Sage. Like, at any moment, boom, you're out. But credit to him. You know he's a qualified engineer? Did you know that? And he could be earning, like, $500,000 every
year. That's a bit dangerous having him in, like, a mine, especially with the way he moves.
That's right. But he loves football so much that he's putting all the money aside. And obviously, he's not getting paid very much to coach Perth Glory. So, but he's a good guy. And
on the bright side, though, Perth is a really crappy place, so obviously apartments would be cheap.
The bright side, far out. All right,
there's no bright side.
Nice bright side, but I think Wellington Phoenix will surprise a lot of people. I saw them in Sydney FC, and they were very evenly matched just a month ago. So I really see them strong. I don't see any duds, so to speak, in the A-League this year.
You know, I honestly think every squad has improved their team.
Yeah, for sure. And I think so. If you got the last place this year and put him in the first season, they would have won.
Yeah,
comfortably.
Oh, definitely. Definitely. The quality has improved so much, especially when you see the coaches and the styles of football that we played. Who would have thought that we'd have like a Barcelona youth coach implementing the Barcelona ways in the A-League?
And it's not only that. We've shied away from that massive marquee. I know we have David Villa, but every team has sort of tried to shy away from having that massive international marquee.
It's not more of the resume now. It's more so of, are you going to improve the squad?
Exactly right. And that is why we are improving by tenfold every season.
David Villa will be a marquee to any club in the world.
Like, definitely.
Champions League winner. Goal scorer in the World Cup, like star player. Then
World Cup winner. I like how he forgets the World Cup.
He just won the Spanish League with Atletico.
Any club in the world would have taken him, at least on the bench.
Oh, definitely.
Club.
Especially Liverpool. They need a lot.
Okay, that's and unwarranted. We're not talking about the EPL today, but anyway.
No, I just had to throw it in there. Just
doesn't make sense, Curtis.
He's happy because they got 3 points.
Yeah.
I love how the jokes have turned.
Back on the A-League.
Yes. How do we see this going? I think the Wellington as well.
Wellington is a tough place to go. If they're going to have a good season, they're going to make Westpac a fortress. They've done it before, and they were successful. So we just have to wait and see with Wellington.
0-0 draw.
Yeah. Moving on to the game of possession on Sunday, I think this is going to be another marquee match. But Brisbane Roar and Adelaide United should be a fantastic clash Sunday on Fox Sports at 5 p.m. The Gombau Revolution. It took him 10 games last season to get into that groove. So it's going to be interesting with a full preseason and the way they've been playing last year to see how they go. But Sunday, 5 p.m. on Fox Sports.
All right, well, we're going to get to a song, and then when we come back, got Simon Hill calling up. We'll talk more about Brisbane and Adelaide as well later on. It's Wireframe 9.9. Stay tuned.
And I saw it coming. I saw emptiness and tragedy. And I felt like running so far away. I knew I had to stay, and I know when I'm older, I look back and I still feel the pain. I know I'll be stronger, and I know I'll be fine for the rest of my days. I've seen better days. Put my face in my hands. Get down on my knees and I pray to God. Hope he sees me through to the end. I noticed most things, but I didn't notice the change. It was hot in the morning, then it turned so cold. Towards the end of the day, there was no conversation. I just felt like I was in space. I needed my friends there. I just turned around. They were gone without a trace. Seen better days. Put my face in my hands. Get down on.
Welcome back to the Real Football on Swire FM 9.9. Simon, can you hear us?
Oh, I'm with you. Yeah, got you.
Simon Hill, correspondent from Fox Sports, commentator, everything, journalist, a god.
That's a very nice intro. I don't think I've had one as nice as that before.
I'm trying to work on my intros with the way that you describe the games.
You need a dictionary for that, unfortunately.
I really, or
as he's known at Fox, Andy Harper.
Yes, I was just about to ask. Yeah, I need those amazing metaphors and similes and everything that he says. But you're at the Melbourne Victory launch today. I think you just came back from it.
That's right.
Many high expectations down there.
Oh, yeah, and I think there always are with Victory, and understandably so. For me, you know, they're still the biggest club in the league. I know Wanderers may well overtake them at some stage, but I think for now, you know, Victory are, they've got the biggest fan base. They've got a culture of success there. And despite that culture of success, they've been 5 years without a trophy. So I think it's time they won something. And for me, they're the favourites this season.
Yeah, the favourites for all three of us in the studio. This is Luke Sarn. I'm going to ask you the big question now.
Oh, he is the Sam Pang of this show.
Yeah, you can say I'm the Sam Pang of this show. Now, I have to ask you, now take this very seriously, okay? Who wears it better, Mark Schwarzer or Roy Keane when it comes to beards?
Ah, no, you're talking my specialist subject here. Actually, I've seen that picture of Schwartzy. He looks quite swarthy, a swarthy Schwartzy, which is not easy to say. But I think Keane wins it because it's just a great big bear of a beard, isn't it? And he's got that wonderful grey thing going on at the front, which unfortunately I have as well.
Look, I respect people's opinions.
And I just rate it.
I respect people's opinions, but Roy Keane looks like a bushwhacker.
Yeah, he does, but it's Grizzly Adams. Made flesh, and he just looks fantastic. Keane wins it for me.
I'd use the word mercurial. Would you be okay with that, Simon?
Yeah, it's like the word mercurial. Good old commentator's cliche, that one.
That's page one in Andy Hopper's dictionary right there.
Not enough syllables, boys.
Simon, it's Anthony here, mate. I'll get down to the serious stuff. But who do you think has best used the transfer market this offseason? Because there's been a lot of changes at a lot of clubs. Who do you think's utilised it best?
A-League-wise.
Well, look, I'll go for two clubs. Again, I'll go back to Victory. I think they've strengthened in every department. Bessel Berisha, of course, goes without saying, the best striker, or certainly the most prolific striker in the competition. So they've strengthened there. They've signed on Carl Valeri. So along with Mark Milligan, they've got the best double pivot in central midfield for me in the competition. Most importantly, they've signed Mathieu Delpierre, a central defender. And look, if he's, you know, anything like his CV, then that will solve a very tricky area of the park for Victory. And don't forget, they've signed a guy called Daniel Georgevski as well. He's come from Macedonia, who can play on either flank. So they've got cover in the fullback areas, and a Tunisian winger called Kalfara, who's got a good CV as well. So Victory is one of the clubs for me. I think they've used it absolutely the best. I'd say Sydney FC are not far behind. It's just that they've tended to concentrate their efforts more in an attacking sense. But when you've added the likes of Smeltz, Abini, Brosk, Yanko, and they've already got Corey Gamero's done great things in pre-season as well, then they're looking, you know, a lot stronger in that area of the park than they were last season. And of course, they've got Graham Arnold as well, who's, I don't know whether you count that as being part of the transfer market, but he's certainly a great acquisition, yeah.
All right. That's all very points. We touched on Melbourne Victory earlier and Sydney FC and all those transfers. Who do you see as, I guess, the underdog of this league? Usually every dark season, there's always that dark horse that look, they don't look fashionable on paper. They don't look great, but they always manage to turn up. For the past few seasons, it's always been the Central Coast Mariners. Who do you expect for big things this season?
Well, look, I don't expect big things from the Mariners, but then I never do, and they always surprise everybody. And, you know, that's why everybody loves the culture of that place. And, again, you know, you look at the squad that they've got this season, you're going, not sure. They've lost a few players, and there's no McGlinchey, and Davini's gone, and Stojoski's retired, and Sainsbury left halfway through last season. You know, have they got enough quality? Don't rule them out.
Yeah.
We just never know with the Mariners. And the fact that they finished in the top three for the last 4 years in a row is incredible, really, given their rather meagre resources. So,
plus, we've all I'd
say the Mariners again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, you mentioned your top two teams for transfers. You didn't mention Man City. Melbourne City. Sorry about that, Simon. Are you now a Melbourne City fan? Well, yeah, you can answer both these questions.
Yes, if I had a dollar for every time I've been asked that question, I'd have at least $100,000. Yeah,
you didn't put them in your top two teams for transfers in the A-League. They've got some big names.
Well, I think it's more because they're, as a club and a team, really, they're such an unknown quantity. Yes, they've made a lot of sign-ins. And on paper, you know, the likes of Damien Duff and Robert Corrin, Eric Partaloo, Aaron Moy, not to mention David Villa, of course, are excellent signings. But you just don't know how they're all going to gel. I mean, it's essentially a new team. And I also think they've still got one or two issues defensively, which they haven't really addressed
in
the transfer market. So, I think they're just an unknown quantity for me.
Touching on those defensive issues like you highlighted, because we talked about Melbourne City. You talk going forward, they look like a new team. They look like a Melbourne City. But in the defence, we see them still as Melbourne Heart. Do you still see that as that way?
Well, yeah, and that's not to say that it's substandard, but I don't think it's perhaps as strong as some of the other clubs. I think, particularly in the fullback areas, I mean, when you consider really that it looks like their first choice is in those positions this season. I could be wrong on this, of course, but, you know, Jason Hoffman at right back, who's a converted winger stroke striker, and at left back, I think they're going with Ian Ramsey, who's more suited, in my opinion, to play him further up the park. Maybe Ben Garuccio will fill in as well. Again, he's a converted left winger. So it's not that I'm saying they're poor players, not by any stretch of the imagination, but I'm not sure that they're, you know, as strong in that particular area as the other clubs. And then, you know, you look in the centre, Paddy Kisnorbo, super stopper, ditto Rob Villard, but have they got the pace at the back? I'm just not sure. It's a bit of a conundrum, so that's why I didn't put them along in the same bracket as Victory and Sydney FC.
Well, I mean, City might be looking like a bit like Manchester City's neighbours then. Great going forward. Big question marks up the back.
Sorry, just repeat that. You just got out of there for a second.
Melbourne City will be looking a bit more like Manchester City's neighbours in Man United. Looking good going forward, but a bit...
United are the Dolly Parton of the English Premier League, aren't they? They're so top-heavy, it's ridiculous. But, anyway, we'll see how they go. I'm sure they'll strengthen in January.
Now, we haven't touched on these guys on the show as yet, and they've flown really under the radar. And we're talking about the champions here, Brisbane Roar. Do you think they can go back-to-back, Simon?
Personally, I don't think they will this year. That's not to say they're not a good side or they won't make the finals, because I think they probably will. But, backing up, winning two titles in a row is very, very difficult. And they have been weakened, in my opinion, by the departure of Berisha and, of course, Ivan Franić as well. Now, it may turn out, and again, you know, I've not seen him yet. I'm sure most people haven't. That Mensur Kutusi is, you know, just as good, if not better, than Berisha. We don't know, but... you know, it's a big ask. So I'd say they might just have come back to the pack a little bit during the off-season.
Yeah, probably a case of 1 year too many for them. Thanks heaps for coming on the show, Simon. Really appreciate it. With the A-League starting, you know, the EPL and the renovations next door, I don't think you'll be getting much sleep. Is that fair to say?
Well, I certainly won't be getting a day off, that's for sure. So, no, we love it. You know, this time of year is all about. It's a job I wouldn't swap for anything.
Thank you so much for coming on, Simon.
Just quickly, Simon, before we go, just want to quickly touch, how do you think we're progressing the Socceroos-wise under Andrew's revolution? How do you think we're going there?
Look, it's okay, but I think the honeymoon's over.
Yeah.
You know, I think people were prepared to cop the three losses in the World Cup. I think they were prepared to cop the fact that, you know, the team needed to be regenerated. But that process is now well underway. I think people want to see a bit of progress.
Yeah.
I know they got a win against Saudi Arabia last time out, but it wasn't hugely convincing, let's be honest.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they want to see good signs ahead of the Asian Cup in January. Because I tell you what, you know, if Ange doesn't go a long way in that tournament, then rightly or wrongly, and I was one of those who called for him to be in the job, but, you know, say they get knocked out in the group or the or the quarterfinals, you know, people won't be happy. So, pressure's on.
Yeah, I agree,
we got to win it. That's it.
Exactly.
The expectation is to win. Not
yeah,
to
I agree. Mm-hmm. I think they've got to lift the trophy.
Yep.
Yeah. Well, thanks again for coming on, Simon.
Thanks a lot.
We wish you the best. And,
no problem.
All right, we'll catch you around. Good luck with the hectic schedule that's coming up. Asian Cup, A-League, Asian Champions League, Socceroos. Have fun.
Thanks, guys. And enjoy the season.
Thanks a lot. We'll do.
Goodbye.
See ya.
That was Simon Hill. Thank him a lot for joining us. Right here on Swipe from 9.9. Before we hand over the reins to JD, we'll actually preview properly Brisbane Roar versus LA Knights, because we have to rush through it, because, you know, when the Lord Simon Hill does call,
the God, what do you mean God? You're downgrading him already. Come on, Curtis.
Isn't Lord God?
Or Chris.
Oh, you're on, oh, right, oh, who cares?
Yeah. Anyway.
Brisbane Roar, LA Knights, probably the two most entertaining teams. We've got Manchester City in Melbourne, we've got Barcelona in South Australia. How do you see LA Knights and Brisbane at Brisbane?
Oh, it's a tough game. I mean, this battle of possession, it's going to be all about that. But I think Simon touched on it. No one knows what Mensur Kattoushi is going to bring. And if he can bring something pretty big, I think it's, you know, do Adelaide have the quality to stop him? But Asama Malik, I think he was Adelaide's best last season. And if he can produce another great year, there's no reason why he can't be in sort of that Asian Cup contention, possibly as a bolter.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm bored of these two teams. Everyone hypes on about Raw, Adelaide. It's not my style. Like, I'm over this. Don't pass for the sake of passing. All right, I'm over that. Like,
don't play out from the back. Long balls, we're talking.
I'm all about the big city.
Top of Stanley, Rose Ed.
Yeah, well, hey, come on.
Hey, mate, it's gotten the job done. All right, we're in the Champions League final.
Relax, Sydney FC. You don't have Champions League to worry about. Okay?
Who's talking about Sydney FC? We're talking about Adelaide of Brisbane and Nikolai Top of Stanley.
Yeah, but no, I think Sirota is with Bratton signing on again in the midfield is a key for them. But regarding strikers, I guess you mentioned Kattoushi. If he goes, awesome. They can contest. If he doesn't, then it's a big trouble. But the real factor is Gone Bow Wow. Gone Bow Wow.
I actually am tipping not only a Gone Bow Wow, but a Mabil Wow. I'm really hoping a lot of things for this player. I mean, last season, he's been around the A-League scene for 2-3 seasons. But last year was, I guess, a more consistent clinical season for him. He's only young. He's about 19 years old.
Yep.
I'm expecting a lot more from him this season. He's a regular feature in the Young Socceroos as well.
FFA Cup, been strong.
And the FFA Cup. He has been strong. That is true. Adelaide, they've signed a player from Spain. I can't remember his name off the top of my head.
Yep.
But he's
Pablo
from
Sanchez Alberto.
That's why Anthony is in the room.
I've got that one.
I was running. I've been here for 2 months wondering why he's here. There it is.
You are the Santo Chirolo. You just love to correct. But it's
and the accents too. Yeah.
Oh, and he's Italian, right? Can't forget that bit. Cannot forget that bit.
Parallels galore here.
But Alan Mabil, I'm expecting a lot from Adelaide United. It's tough to say a lot in the A-League because it's only a 10-team competition. A lot in the Premier League can get you to Champions League. A lot in the A-League, you know, can get you to 8th spot, and that's still a good year. So Brisbane or Adelaide, Simon Hill did, I guess, he did not underrate Brisbane. He still said, you know, they'll be a contender, but he's tipping Melbourne victory. I still think they'll challenge. I'm not going to go out and say Kattoushi is as good as Berisha. I had to have no one knows.
Exactly right.
No one knows. I still think Berisha is better than Kattoushi. I'm just hoping Solazano can get back to where he was a few years ago when Brisbane did beat Central Coast.
He was a bit poor last season.
But he's had a proper preseason. He'd come like halfway through last season. So Brisbane and Adelaide, I'm expecting some challenges.
How big is the loss of Matt Theo? He's gone for 8 weeks, broken wrist. Jamie Young, who's just returned from overseas, hasn't had a lot of playing time overseas. How big of a loss is Theo to this team?
It is, but with goalkeepers, the thing is that those who are underrated are still great because it's a position where you don't have to be the best and you still perform really, really well.
I can't believe they let him change his name from Theoklitos to Theo.
I'm still calling him Theoklitos.
I'm still getting over that, so I can't talk about
him. Be proud of him.
That's about all I'm going to say about Theoklitos.
I don't
who's Theoklitos? That's technically no one.
I don't respond
to
Theo.
It doesn't exist.
No, Theo's not real.
All right. Watch all the A-League games this weekend. Australia game plays Saturday morning. On Saturday morning, around 1 o'clock, 1:30 against UAE. In a few days later, they do play Qatar. We'll start with Melbourne Victory. Do play Western Sydney, SBS, and Fox Sports.
Thank God it's back.
Have to watch it.
If you're in Melbourne somehow, get to the area. It's gonna be packed. It's gonna be amazing. I'm savvy. We love the NRL, but thank God that's over.
Every game's interesting.
It is.
I'm pumped.
I'm over Sam Burgess now. His facial fractures. That's it. Just step aside. Let the A-League take centre stage.
Let
that's
those it. Who get their hands trotted on and they'll grab their knee. Wincing. That's where real men is.
Yes.
We eat concrete in football. Yeah. When our hand hurts, we hold our knee. That's what we do. That's
preach,
what we
Curtis.
Do.
Preach, Curtis. Preach it, brother.
When we get hurt, we roll around and that causes more pain.
Yeah. So right. The more rolls, the more pain.
The more men play football, the real football.
Yes.
Sorry, friends. Stay tuned for Swire Drive. We'll catch you guys next week from 3 to 4.
See you guys.
Thanks for tuning in. Stay tuned to IFM 9.9.
The 70s till now, right here, and featuring local programs.